story. Tiffany?
Well, Camille, today's development comes after years of court battles, fines, and racial undertones. And the legal fees have been nothing short of expensive. We wanted to know who's paying the legal cost, and we got answers. The legal tussle between St. Bernard Parish and Provident Realty is getting a lot of reaction from neighbors.
The housing, that's ridiculous. It's really ridiculous.
I think it's bull.
Many of them frustrated with the drawn-out fight over four mixed-income housing developments in Chalmette. But late this afternoon, after 3 years of legal wrangling, parish leaders issued building permits for three of the four sites. Today's development comes after the parish refused to meet a court-imposed deadline to issue the permits. A judge fined the parish $40,000 for not meeting the Friday deadline.
I think it's in the best interest financially of the people of St. Bernard Parish.
Councilman-at-large Frank Audra says disagreements among parish leaders held up the process. But now the question is, who pays the $40,000? Parish President Craig Tefero says the money will come from the parish's legal department reserve. But the legal fees don't just stop at the recent fines. Since 2008, the legal battle has cost the parish hundreds of thousands of dollars. Right now, a legal liability insurance fund is covering the fees. There's about $1.5 million left in that fund, and the money could soon be exhausted if the parish is ordered to pay Provident Realty's legal fees.
We've been informed that that bill probably would be in the neighborhood of $1 million, so it don't leave us a great deal of money to deal with.
Aldra says if the fight continues, eventually parish leaders would have to dip into the general fund, which means taxpayers could soon pick up the tab. Now tonight, St. Bernard Parish President Craig Tefero said in a statement, "We have led the Gulf Coast region in recovery for 3 years because our residents, returning anew, have committed to building a great St. Bernard. These apartments are one fight in a long list of obstacles that we have faced. We'll work through this one as well." Tefero also says the parish is appealing the $40,000 fine. Of course, we'll keep you posted on what happens. Camille.
All right, Tiffany. And also, we wanted to know exactly what can $10,000 a day pay for in St. Bernard Parish. Parish President Craig Tefero says that amount of money could fund 1,000 yards of new sidewalks. And one councilman tells us $10,000 could fill unlimited potholes in the parish and fix dozens of downed street signs.